Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a look at the North American stock markets for Wednesday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are up sharply, so we are looking for some aggressive buying at the open on Wednesday morning. I'd like to start off this morning's presentation on a personal note. I previously mentioned I wasn't going to do any videos this week, but circumstances changed yesterday, and I needed a little mental break. As many of you know, I've been keeping a very low profile for the last couple of years, not taking on new members, not going on television. And the reason for that is that I've had two elderly parents that were having a hard time, and so focused a lot of my time and effort on that. Last week, things changed dramatically. Both of them ended up in emergency, and while my mom is recovering fairly well, she'll still be in hospital for the next few months. Unfortunately, we lost my dad yesterday. He was just 2 weeks shy of his 83rd birthday, and I think he was really trying to outlast the Queen, but unfortunately that's not the way things turned out. So I will be off until sometime next week. This is the last video I'm going to make for a while. Now, on a positive note, if there is a positive note to be found, the studio audience for my morning videos has now doubled. We've adopted the parents' cat. Cat's named Tabby. He's a young boy. And who knew? Cats like dog food and dogs like cat food. They're still sorting out whose food bowl is whose at the moment. But they've known each other for a while and they tolerate each other. I don't think there's any love here. They will sit on the same couch together. They will walk down the same hallway together. But they are certainly not talking to each other about anything at the moment. So that's one positive note. Given what's going on, I'll be off for probably the next week or so from doing pre-market videos, and then we'll get back to it after that. The markets right now, everybody's impressed with what happened in Japan overnight, and that fueled buying in Hong Kong. It also fueled buying in Shanghai, not enough to give us a buy signal just yet. Looking at the North American markets, we're currently in an inside week of an inside week. And so, of course, the first task is to break out above last week's high at 1986.73. And then, of course, we have the previous week's high, which we couldn't break out above last week, up at 1993.48. And so those are two possible targets to the upside. The major trend, of course, is still down. The short-term trend is turning up. Notice how wide these channels are. These are linear regression channels. If we go back just 2 months into July, you can see how thin that channel is, and that's the type of volatility we were seeing back then, and that has certainly changed. So seeing the futures up 20 points in the pre-market is kind of the norm right now. Now, we talked previously about the Elliott wave theory and the five waves down, and of course we still have targets to the upside that would give us that fourth wave, and then the fifth wave would start to the downside. Of course, that's just all theory. It's called the Elliott wave theory. I like to watch it because I like numbers. It was one of the first things I learned about. I love Fibonacci ratios. I love the Elliott wave theory. It's all subjective. You can have three-wave count. You can have a three-wave count, a five-wave count, an ABC count. So it's all subjective. You ask five different Elliott wave analysts to analyze the market, and they'll come up with five different theories of what's going to happen next. So we're looking still for a bounce up here before we start heading lower again. And we do have another open gap to deal with. And if you look at the chart there, there's an open gap up there for the S&P 500 cash index. And there's still lots of gaps in this market that can act as not only price targets, but potential areas of resistance. If you're interested in the Elliott wave theory, type in MT Predictor in YouTube and they put up a weekly video. I don't think they put up anything last week. They're probably on holidays. MT Predictor in YouTube, subscribe to their channel. They put up a weekly video if you're interested in Elliott wave theory and market analysis. The VIX so far has not generated a sell signal, and the VIX, so the S&P 500 cash index has not generated a buy signal. That could certainly change today. The NASDAQ, you can see the VIX has generated a sell signal. The NASDAQ itself has generated a buy signal. So we're seeing leadership there from technologies. And believe it or not, has a lot to do with semiconductors. The TSX is currently in the channel, so nothing going on there. While the stock markets are going all over the place, the financial markets are fairly quiet. There's the 30-year bond not doing anything. There's the U.S. dollar not doing anything. So it's really the stock market at the moment. Now, one of the things I'm looking at is U.S. banks to see if they can get back on their feet. And certainly that would give me a lot more confidence in the market if we could get banks back on a buy signal. There's who's in control at the moment. You can see that the pros are nowhere near taking control this morning. And so that may take a little time to work out if it's going to work out anytime soon. Looking at stocks, there's a set of stocks called the FANG stocks. And we can just take a look at those and see how they're doing. They're all market leaders. There is Facebook on still on a buy signal from a couple of weeks ago. Closed below 87.24 today would give us a sell signal. Not expecting that to happen. There's Amazon on a buy signal with a close below 499.72 on today, generating a sell signal. Not expecting that to happen. Looking at Apple Computer, I threw that one in as well. Apple Computer, we're looking for a close today above 112.37 to give us a buy signal. That could certainly happen. Came pretty darn close yesterday, just off by 6 cents. There's Google, still looking for a close above 655.31. And Netflix heading in the opposite direction. We need a close today above 110.72 to give us a buy signal. So those are the FANG stocks people are talking about. For commodity prices, no major changes here. We still have crude oil on a buy signal and gold on a sell signal. That hasn't changed at all. And a quick look at the 60-minute charts. You can see the VIX hasn't broken down below the 200-hour moving average, and that would certainly be bullish for the market if it could. It would also be bullish for the market if we could get the S&P 500 cash index above its 200-hour moving average. You can see there we're stuck at the 100-hour. That's as high as we've gotten. We were able to cross the 50-hour several times and head back lower. Looking at the NASDAQ, we're starting to slip above the 100-hour moving average with the 200 potentially acting as a target and resistance. And there we have the SOX index breaking out above the 200-hour moving average. Looking north of the border, the TSX is squeezed in between the 50 and the 100-hour moving average. And last up this morning, we're looking at the XAU, and of course it's underperforming the market right now. And as you would expect, it's having trouble getting over the 50-hour moving average. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. The markets are opening higher. We'll have to see if we can break out above the previous 2 weeks highs and hold it. I am still looking for a retest of the recent low and a possible move down to 1750 on the S&P 500 cash index. That obviously is not starting today. September and October have histories of extreme volatility and major moves to the downside. Of course, off those major moves come the rally into the end of the year, and I don't think that low has been made just yet. Thank you very much for your patience and understanding. Next time you'll hear my voice is probably next Thursday or Friday, and at that time we'll get back on our feet and start doing a lot more videos. Thank you very much, and we'll talk to you again soon.